magnetization and magnetic materials. So what is magnetization? In classical electromagnetic, magnetization is the vector field which express the density of permanent or induced magnetic dipole moment in a magnetic material. The moment within this field is described by a direction and it is either axial or diametric. So the origin of the magnetic moment responsible for magnetization can be either microscopic electric current resulting from the motion of the electrons in the atoms or the spin of the electrons or the nuclei. So the net magnetization results from the response of material to an external magnetic field. An internal magnetic field is produced by the electrons orbiting around the nucleus and spinning of the electrons, and this is similar to the magnetic field which is produced by a current loop. So an internal magnetic field is produced by the electrons orbiting around the nucleus and spinning of the electrons, and it is similar to the magnetic field which is produced by a current loop. So the equivalent current loop has a magnetic moment, whereas S is the area of the loop and IB is the current bound to the atom. नेट मैग्नेटाइजेशन रिजल्ट्स फ्रॉम द रिस्पॉन्स ऑफ मटेरियल टू एन एक्सटर्नल मैग्नेटिक फील्ड एंड द पैरामैग्नेटिक मटेरियल्स हैव अ वीक इंड्यूस्ड मैग्नेटाइजेशन इन द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड विच डिसअपीयर्स व्हेन द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज रिमूव्ड. सो मैग्नेटाइजेशन इज नॉट नेसेसरली यूनिफॉर्म विद इन अ मटेरियल बट इट मे वेरी बिटवीन अ डिफरेंट पॉइंट. मैग्नेटाइजेशन ऑल्सो डिस्क्राइब्ड हाउ मटेरियल रिस्पॉन्ड्स टू एन अप्लाइड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड एज वेल एज द वे द मटेरियल चेंजेस द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड एंड इट कैन बी यूज टू कैलकुलेट द फोर्सेस विच रिजल्ट्स फ्रॉम दोज इंट्रैक्शंस. इट कैन बी कंपेयर टू द इलेक्ट्रिक पोलराइजेशन विच इज़ द मेजर ऑफ करस्पॉन्डिंग रिस्पॉन्स ऑफ मटेरियल टू एन इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इन द इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक. सो मैग्नेटिज्म इज अ क्लास ऑफ फिजिकल एट्रीब्यूट विच आर मेडिएटेड बाय अ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. द इलेक्ट्रिक करंट एंड मैग्नेटिक मूवमेंट्स ऑफ एलिमेंट्री पार्टिकल्स गिव राइज टू अ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड विच एक्ट्स ऑन अदर करंट्स एंड मैग्नेटिक मूवमेंट्स. मैग्नेटिज्म इज वन आस्पेक्ट ऑफ द कंबाइंड फिनोमेनन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिज्म. So all the substances which exhibit some type of magnetism, the magnetic material are classified according to their bulk susceptibility. The ferromagnetism is responsible for the most of the effect of magnetism which are encountered in everyday life. But there are actually several types of magnetism. So magnetization and magnetic material. Now, without an external field applied to the material, the sum of the moments is zero due to random orientation. When external field is applied, the magnetic moment of the electrons align themselves with B so that the net magnetic moment is not zero, and the magnetization is the magnetic dipole moment per unit volume. There are number of elements which are attracted by the magnet, commonly referred as a magnetic. So these are the same material which can be magnetized to create a permanent magnet, and the magnetic materials are categorized as magnetically hard or magnetically soft material. The magnetically soft materials are easily magnetized, but the induced magnetism is usually temporary. For example, if we rub a permanent magnet along a nail or a screwdriver, then the nail or screwdriver will become temporarily magnetized and it will emit their own weak magnetic field. And this is because a large number of their ion atoms are temporarily aligned in the same direction by the external magnetic field. Now, like magnetically soft materials, the magnetically hard materials can be magnetized by a strong external magnetic field such that though generated by an electromagnet. The difference being that magnetically hard material magnetically hard materials will remain magnetized indefinitely unless they are demagnetized by an opposing magnetic field raised above their Curie temperature or allowed to carry. So magnetically hard materials are used to create a permanent magnet made from alloy generally consisting of varying amount of iron, aluminium, nickel, cobalt and rare earth element. The strongest permanent magnet are known as are made from an alloy of alloy of iron and boron. These are difficult to magnetize as unlike magnetically soft materials, their atomic magnetic domain aren't easily aligned. So for all materials, the value of B is given here. Depending on the values of permeability, the magnetic properties of the materials are determined. So when material is placed within a magnetic field, then the magnetic force of materials, the magnetic forces of the material's electrons will be affected, and this effect is known as Faraday's law of magnetic induction. However, the materials can react quite differently to the presence of external magnetic field, and this reaction is dependent on a number of factors such as the atomic and molecular structure of the material and the net magnetic field associated with the atoms. So the magnetic moments associated with the atoms have three regions: electron motion, change in motion caused by an external magnetic field, and spin of the electrons. Now, the materials with some unpaired electrons will have a net magnetic field and it will react more to an external field. So most materials are classified as diamagnetic, paramagnetic and ferromagnetic. So what is diamagnetic? The diamagnetic materials have a weak negative susceptibility to a magnetic field. The diamagnetic materials are slightly repelled by the magnetic field and it do not retain the magnetic properties when external field is removed. In diamagnetic materials, all the electrons are paired, so there is no permanent net magnetic moment per atom, and the diamagnetic properties arise from the realignment of the electron path under the influence of an external magnetic field. So most elements in the periodic table, including copper, silver, gold, are diamagnetic. Now paramagnetic means the paramagnetic materials have a small positive susceptibility to magnetic field, and these materials are slightly attracted by a magnetic field and it do not retain the magnetic properties. So when the external field is removed, the paramagnetic material properties are due to the presence of some unpaired electrons and from the realignment of the electron path caused by the external magnetic field. So the paramagnetic materials include a magnesium, lithium and tantalum. Now ferromagnetic materials have third is ferromagnetic materials. These ferromagnetic materials have large positive susceptibility to an external magnetic field. They exhibit a strong attraction to the magnetic field, and these are able to retain their magnetic properties after the external field has been removed. Ferromagnetic material have some unpaired electrons, so their atoms have a net magnetic moment. They get their strong magnetic properties due to the presence of magnetic domain
In this domain, large number of atoms moments are aligned parallel so that the magnetic force within the domain is strong. When ferromagnetic material is in the unmagnetized state, the domains are nearly randomly organized and the net magnetic field for the part as whole is zero. When magnetizing force is applied, the domain become aligned to produce a strong magnetic field within the part. The iron, nickel and cobalt are examples of ferromagnetic material, and the components with these material are commonly inspected using the magnetic particle methods. Now the next is boundary conditions. In homogeneous media, the electromagnetic quantities are very smoothly and continuously. So at boundary between the dissimilar media, it is possible for electromagnetic quantities to be discontinuous. Now here equations for the boundary conditions of the magnetic fields are given. Now the next is law of refraction. So with k is equal to 0, the tangential component is continuous and the tangential component b is discontinuous at the boundary. So theta 1 and theta 2 be the angles which are made by a field with normal to the interface.
So here are the equations for the magnetic force. Force on the current element. The force on current element carrying conductor due to the magnetic field. This diagram shows the force between the two current elements. Then the next is the magnetic torque. The torque T, or mechanical moment of force on the loop, is the vector product of the force and the moment R. So for rectangular loop, the length, land, width W is placed in a uniform magnetic field, and the magnetic dipole moment is the product of the current and the area of the loop in the direction which is normal to the loop. Next is the application. So the first application is radio frequency micro electromechanical system, second is magnetic levitation, and third is electromagnetic pump. So first application, the RFMEMS, that is radio frequency micro electromechanical system. The REMEMS switches, switched capacitors, varactors, vibrating RF resonators. The actuation methods are electrostatic, electrothermal, magnetostatic, and piezoelectric. So electrostatically are actuated switches, electrostatically actuated RF switches, low insertion loss, high isolation, good linearity, high electrical quality factor Q, and capacitor fixed beam switch. A micro machine capacitor with a moving top electrode beam, and beam is suspended over a lower electrode separated by an air gap and dielectric and connected in shunt with a transmission line. The frequency range is 8 to 110 gigahertz. So reliable long life RF capacitive switch is provided with a dielectric layer which is comprising a fast discharge diamond dielectric layer and enabling rapid switch recovery, dielectric layer charging and discharging which is efficient and effective to enable the switch. Next is magnetic levitation. So it uses an electromagnetic field to levitate things without any noise or the need for a liquid fuel or air by floating one magnetic over the other. Static levitation is stable suspension of object against gravity. Then diamagnetic materials are superconductors, expels a magnetic field. The types are electromagnetic levitation uses an attractive force between electromagnet on the levitated object and the circuit on the ground. Then electrodynamic levitation makes the use of repulsive force between a superconductive magnet on levitated object and the induced current in the secondary circuit on ground. Then it consists of three subsystems: magnetic suspension, propulsion motor, and the power system. So here is the diagram. The magnetic suspension ensures a stable suspension in its own magnetic field, and the propulsion motor produces force sufficient for a movement of the vehicle along the track with the assigned speed. Example of this is levitating trains. Now it is suspended in air above the track and propelled forward using a repulsive and attractive forces of magnetism. Advantage is that the ability to operate in all weather condition. Then the next diagram shows the magnetic levitation. Then the third is electromagnetic pump. So here Lonet's force law is used to circulate a liquid metal through a desired path. So the types are AC or linear electromagnetic pump. A liquid metal is used to flow between two stator winding in an enclosure, and the polyphase winding carried by a stator energizes producing a rotating magnetic field, inducing eddy current in the liquid metal. The current interact with the field to develop a force which circulates metal through a desired path. Then applications are in circular breeder reactors. Then electromagnetic pump, DC electromagnetic pump, current is forced into the liquid metal through the electrodes and the liquid moves in direction determined by a Fleming left hand rule. So here diagram of the AC pump and DC pump are shown here. Then the next is here is a link which shows for the electromagnetic pump. Thank you.